Greetings, YouTube. It's your boy, OG Ant, back with another episode of Heroes. We're here to watch and react to the latest hijinks of Who Won Jaw and Big Sword Wang Wu. We want to see what's happening with them. So we hope you like this episode. We're going to give it a watch. Let's go.
Shifu, 您真知道啊? 那您还答应他?
兄弟, 你可知道大哥与你结拜的深意?
Oh, they're sworn blood brothers now. Sworn blood brothers.
真知道假知道啊?
大哥想劫狱救出谭大人, 又担心我靠不住, 所以才抬举我。
胡说! 我大刀王武一生坦荡, 岂能利用结拜拉拢人?
难道大哥不想救出谭大人?
我是想拜托兄弟。
Okay, so right off the bat, there's a question as to whether or not Big Sword Wang Wu made a blood brother pact with Hu Won Ja just so that he could get his assistance because he knows that Hu Won Ja's student works for the guards. So there's this, I guess, this question as to whether or not he really wanted to be his blood brother, or did he, is he just using him? Using him to get access to his student who will help Lord Tan to escape.
不贪大人,
大哥是何意啊? 兄弟越来越糊涂了。 师父, 我也越来越糊涂了。大刀王武到底什么意思啊? 他怕连累你。
您的徒弟刘振生, 是你们霍家用银子买来的差事。 如果他出事, 那你和你们霍家 恐怕都会遭殃。
所以大哥要有万全之策。大哥说来听听。明日进得牢房，你带谭大人走。那大哥您呢？兄弟走之前，受累，成全我。王武是想替谭嗣同死。是。大哥是希望我把谭大人先带走，然后制造一个谭大人试图越狱的假象，他让你用刀把他的脸和全身砍烂，让验尸官难辨真伪。 这样，你既避免了受牵连，又有可能立功。
师父，大刀王武乃当世豪杰，武林人士要知道是我，那后半辈子我还怎么做人？
我就知道你会这么说，所以我没有答应。你不答应，从此以后就别认我这个大哥。哼！您怕连累我，要用自己的命去换谭大人，这份侠肝义胆。 袁家敬佩不已，但是我不能答应。第一，朝廷没有那么好糊弄，万一露出了破绽，前功尽弃，枉搭了您一条性命。第二，就算侥幸蒙混过关，天下人皆知谭嗣同已死，那活着的谭大人还能有何作为啊？第三，你我皆是习武之人，做事应该光明磊落。
砸牢劫狱就是砸牢劫狱，何必要作假骗人呢？
袁家，你有没有想过，一旦，那么从此以后，你恐怕一生都会隐姓埋名，浪迹江湖。浪迹江湖？难道大哥不陪我？袁家此生。 能和大哥并肩行走江湖，岂不快哉？师父，振生，如果为师让你脱下这身官服，陪我行走江湖。
Early on, it seems to be this theme of brotherhood that's kind of built into the script, and I really dig that. I dig the honor and the brotherhood that's kind of built early on into the script. So, liking that so far is really it's very touching. I dig it.
愿意吗，师父？我这条命是霍家给的，这辈子无论上刀山、下火海，我都陪着你。
This is exactly what I'm talking about. This right here. It's fantastic. I love it. Music is really good here. It's like creating atmosphere, like suspense, like, oh my God, are they going to get caught? Are they going to get, are they going to be found out? What's going to happen? I can feel my heart starting to race. This is great. There's Lord Tan. He's just meditating.
It's
a trap.
你说什么? 大胆王, 跪下! 这是什么地方? 你竟敢私闯, 意欲何为? 大人, 我, 我...
谭大人, 王武大哥是来救您的,
住口! 我在教训他, 轮得到你插嘴吗? 王武，事变之夜，我就命你离开京城。你为何不走？谭大人身陷囹圄，王武岂能独善其身？你本是江湖中人。
Lord Tan does not want to be rescued. I think he is. I think he's relegated himself to being a martyr. It would appear that he doesn't want to be rescued, and I think at some point, Big Sword Wang Wu is going to have to come to terms with that. It doesn't look like this guy wants to be saved. That's just my opinion.
好勇斗狠，多年来官府不追究你，已经是法外开恩。今日你还想砸牢劫狱不成？正是，谭大人。 您有所不知，满街贴满了告示，朝廷已经翻脸了。明天就要砍您的头，如果我不来救您的话，您就没命了。哼，明日就是大限之期，我焉能不知？谭大人，您知道了。8月13，好日子。
日后你只需在中秋月圆之夜敬我一杯酒就行了。不必单独祭奠。
谭大人，您说什么呢？只要王武一口气在，绝不让朝廷枉杀好人。那日您不走，是对皇上没有死心，对朝廷没有死心。可是今天，皇上已经被慈禧囚禁，朝廷上下再也没有一个明白人了，不许。
哇哦，哇哦！别论语，谭大人，我知道您是忠臣，讲道理我讲不过您。我王武一介草莽，不怕什么王法，更不怕别人告我造反。我的结义兄弟冒死助我，就是为了救您谭大人走。我已进入死牢，此事再也没有回旋余地，走不走，由不得您。兄弟，动手，将谭大人打晕。
He'll take him by force. Let's knock Lord Tan out and carry him out of here against his will. That's not smart. The man don't want to go. He's, like I said, he's resigned himself to his fate. Hey, let that man live or not live, for that matter.
扛着他走，也罢。哦，难得你对我忠心耿耿，我就听你一回。
谭大人，你想明白了。不过，你得先帮我办件事儿。
您说。 去一下我的住处，在我的书桌下有一个暗格，内藏当今圣上亲授的秘旨，这秘旨对设计至关重要。你先把此物取回，我再跟你们一起走。
这不行啊，我们好不容易混了进来，机不可失，失不再来，错过了这个时辰恐怕就救不了您了。要不这样，您跟我们一起走，回到您的府上之后拿了秘旨，我们一起再逃出城去，如何？
不可，我离开死亡非同小可，京城会一片大乱，各路官兵会四处抓捕，就没有机会再取回秘旨。
谭大人，现在都什么时候了，您还要那个傀儡皇帝的秘旨有什么用啊？
放肆！皇上的秘旨比我的命都重要，你若不给我取来，我绝不跟你走。
冤家动手！
用不着别人动手。今日虽无宝剑，但你要是非逼我，我就一头撞死在这儿。
That's probably gonna hurt. So, in the middle of his rescue attempt, he's gonna send Big Sword Wang Wu on a quick journey, go back to my house and get this document. Meanwhile, Hu Wenjia and his student are left basically holding the bag. Where are the guards? Where are the guards that's supposed to be walking around and making sure that everything's kosher? I don't get it.
Please. 那我陪你站会儿。
这更不敢。谭大人，您坐。
Oh, he wants to have a private conversation with Hu Wenjia. I wonder.
刚才听王武叫你元甲。
在下天津静海霍元甲，字俊卿。
俊卿兄也是习武之人？
自幼习武。
俊卿兄贵庚啊？
虚度光阴30载。
我虚长你3岁。刚才王武说你是他的结义兄弟
啊。蒙大哥抬爱，昨日刚刚义结进来。
能被叱咤江湖的大刀王武看中，你也是大侠吧？
那都是江湖上的谬赞。
虽说谭某不懂武学，却知古往今来能称侠者皆义士，能赴汤敢蹈火。今日你与王武大哥一同到死牢里来救我，便是侠士之举。
Oh, he found it.
霍贤弟怎么看？洋人称我国人为东亚病夫。
洋人，可恶，自大。
Unfortunately, this is true. The West, particularly the United States, we had a history of being incredibly racist towards people from Asia, specifically Chinese people, back in the day. So,
若他们敢向我挑衅，我一定会打倒他们。
好。其实，洋人之所以狂妄，也不无原因啊。甲午一战，北洋水师惨败，使我朝廷丧权辱国，割地赔款。多年来谭嗣同夜不能寐，深究我中华除科学和制度之外比洋人还差了什么。我以为是尚武精神的丧失，西洋骑士 和日本武士传统从未泯灭，而我中华自唐之后历朝历代频频颁布限武令，更令我民族雪上加霜，时至今日。
Wow, this is directly correlated to that. Yeah, when they disbanded martial arts teaching, and they, you know, basically destroyed the Shaolin temples back in the day. All of this is connected. That's great. I love that historical reference. Nice. Nice job.
我同胞中又有几个像霍贤弟这般身强体健、气宇轩昂，更有很多国人受鸦片之害，骨瘦如柴，精神萎靡，故而若想复兴我民族，仅靠公卿自上而。
Yeah, and the introduction of opium to Chinese culture also contributed to that decline as well. So, wow, I love this. I love that they've connected all of this because I'm not sure if this is based in nonfiction or fact, rather, but they're doing a really good job of at least connecting it in a way that makes this feel very real, like these characters actually did live. So this is, yeah, this is fantastic.
下的变法是不够的，还需要各行各业的奋起，各行各业的自强。比如身在武林的霍贤弟。
这么说，袁家虽一介武夫，也能为民族的复兴尽力。
Okay, he's back now.
Tan 大人，您看，
多谢王武大哥。
哎，谭大人，你我早就有过约定，您是朝廷的重臣，不可与我这一介武夫称兄道弟啊。
无妨，刚才我跟霍贤弟相谈甚欢，还一起唱往妾放白鹿青崖间，虚行祭旗访名山的生活。
那太好了，
来，我们俩还约定日后都管你叫大哥。
这怎么能行呢？袁家，谭大人，袁家大还小，不懂事。
哇哇 ！It's one of those WTF moments. Whoa! I was not expecting that. I was not expecting that. I'm freaking out. Why did he knock him out? He just struck him from behind. They must have.Maybe they didn't show it. Maybe it was off camera. But while they were continuing that conversation, apparently Lord Tan and Huan Jia have decided to knock out Big Brother, Big Sword Wang Wu. So we'll see what happens. But it's getting crazy right now. Oh, there he is. Woo, look at that face.A face that only a mother could love. Oh, okay, so that's Big Sword Wang Wu when he was young, no beard. And this is the bad guy. Looks like he's the chief of the guards. He's got a dope staff. It's like an eagle's claw at the end of it. That's pretty fly. So it looks like Big Sword Wang Wu and him had a fight in the past and he lost. So...That's probably why he has a grudge against him. So this should be interesting.
天饶命，我一定痛改前非。大侠， 饶了我吧。
李大人，咱们已经在这联手四天了，大刀王五应该不会来了吧。
你 set a trap。Oh, wow.
李大人，李大人。
Lord Liu。
绝不可能。王五死心追随谭嗣同，
他不可能不救。
准是有人走漏了风声。望门投止，思张俭，人死须臾待杜根。我自横刀向天笑，去留肝胆两昆仑。
Oh, he wrote that on the wall. Oh, he didn't escape.
Hu Xian Di, 实不相瞒，变法失败的消息，我是头一个知道的。
那您为什么不赶紧离开京城啊？
我命人通知了老师和梁大人，而我自己故意不走。
这是为什么？
羸弱之中华，若不变法难得新生。但据我所知，各国变法皆由流血开始，我们不成功，就是因为无人为此而死。为改变腐朽的朝廷，唤醒沉睡的国人，必须有人为此付出生命的代价。我谭嗣同誓用项上人头，警醒世人，感召后代。
那您刚才，
王五大哥耿直，我怕短时间之内舒服不了他，所以先把他支走，就是为了说服霍先帝。
说服我？
谭嗣同，牺牲之心已决绝。
Exactly, he said it. I'm determined to sacrifice myself. He doesn't want to be rescued, so.He convinced Huan Jia to knock out Big Sword Wang Wu so that he could take him out of here so that he can die in peace the following morning. It's clear. He's written his final words on the wall. He's prepared himself. He's ready to sacrifice himself and be the martyr that China needs. It's that simple.
但不想连累他，所以请先帝助我。
When Big Sword Wang Wu wakes up, he's gonna be pissed. It's interesting. We're halfway through this episode and not a single punch or kick has been thrown. So clearly this show is either doing one or two things. Either it's building its dramatic prose and making sure that, you know, we're invested in the story and then the martial arts will come later. Or this is one of those TV shows where there's not that much martial arts. But I can't imagine that that's the case. I just can't imagine it. So, but they're doing a really good job of laying out the story, being very dramatic. Again, halfway through, not a single fight scene.
<笑>但别为我收尸，免得连累你和你的家人。你为国为民，忠心耿耿，袁家要给你埋一口好棺材厚葬。<笑><笑>
一身臭皮囊，狗叼鸭啄，又何妨？不仅你不能替我收尸，你还要拦住王五大哥，也绝不能让他替我收尸。这又是为何？Wants
to be a martyr.
王五大哥在江湖上赫赫有名，又嫉恶如仇，得罪了很多人，有些人 早就想利用这个机会害死他，袁家不能让那些枭雄得逞。Oh
my lord. Holy crap. And they tied him up and gagged him. Oh my god. You know who's going to take this out on? Who won Ja? Oh, baby.
Aya, 别等了。
这怪晒得慌的，我都被烤得流油了。可惜啊，谭大人是好人呐。谭大人，霍元甲来送您来了。谭大人，请给世人留几句话吧。
杀贼，无力回天，死得其所，快哉，快哉！下面那个带头闹事的，刚才他自己说，他叫什么来着？
Oh, crap. So he yelled his name out in a huge crowd announcing himself. So now the bad guys know his name and know who he is. That wasn't a smart move.
<笑>霍元甲，有名没名？
此人在天津卫可是大大的有名啊！
干什么的？土匪？
武林中人，练拳的。
哼，一个拳师，他哪来这么大胆子？
我怀疑他跟大刀王五是一伙的，是叛党的帮凶。
之前你说的那个大刀王五，还会不会来？应该会来。哎呀！
你应该不行啊，到底会不会来？一定会来。<笑>
玄甲。
不能再等了，再等刁民会生乱的。催魂枪。
Oh snap, he's on his way, he's running. Wow, symbolism. Little butterfly landed on his shoulder. Check that out. And I believe in Five Deadly Venoms, the general played by Wang Lung Wei did the same thing whenever he executed an order, like when he told them to execute the toad. He used this same instrument. I don't know what it's called, but it's like a decree or an order, and he throws it out onto the ground, meaning execute the order. It's pretty cool. I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I don't think I could do it. I couldn't lay my head down on a wooden plank and voluntarily expose my neck, allowing you to chop my head. Right when I'm thinking, I'll be like, wait, hold on. I don't know how anyone could just lay there and allow someone to chop their head off. That's weird, but that's just me. Too late. It's over. My guess is he's going to be so angry at Huan Jia that there probably will be a fight. He's probably going to challenge him and be like, no, we're going to fight to the death. You betrayed me. You're supposed to be my blood brother. You knocked me out. You betrayed me. And at least, again, this is my guess. I'm not sure. I knew it. I knew that was coming. He like, hey, I was here for you. I was there. I got to see him. He had an honorable death. He died a martyr. And I was here. I represented you. He looked at him like, is you crazy? Bow! Knew that was coming.
哥, 兄弟对不起你, 但这是谭大人的主意。他
It's
Lord Tan's idea. He's like, my foot. You are Imperial Dog. He knocked me out. He stopped me from saving him. You're with them. Here come the fight. Oh! He is whooping his ass. Oh, here come his students. Stand down. Stand down. It's between me and him. Y'all stand back. Wow, this guy has a huge head. That's just a side note. He has a huge head. He's headstrong. He's ahead of the game. Wow.
大哥, 谭大人, 是想用鲜血, 警醒世人, 感召后代。
谭大人的心思, 用得着你说。 火阳甲, 你既然已经来到了法场, 为什么不救谭大人?
朝廷, 下令斩杀谭大人等六人, 劫法场, 也是犯上作乱。 不但我不能, 大哥你也不能。
贪生怕死，你就不要答应我。既然承诺，就不救，你就是小人。师傅，师傅，不要过来！火焰侠，你为何不还手？谭大人罹难，大哥心里不舒服。若打我可以解气，大哥尽管打。兄弟绝不还手。
Wow, he's like, he's dead and gone, and if beating me up is going to take away your hurt, then hit me as many times as you like. He's like, fight me, fight back, fight back. He's like, no, I won't. Oh, he's going to the sword. 师父，师父，师兄。Wow. Banged him on the side of his head.
Tan 大人的尸首何在？
Liu Yang 会馆一位姓刘的，一位姓胡的，还有一位姓罗的，给大人收了尸。
是老常班刘风池，还有罗生、胡立臣，他们三位都是谭大人的生前好友，重情讲义之人。我告诉你，这三位均曾经向我示好，想与我大刀王五结拜成兄弟，我都没答应。我真是瞎了眼了，误了三位英雄好汉的厚爱，却与你这小人一起亲兰。 大哥，别叫我大哥。昨日我与你结拜，今日大刀王五与你割袍断义。从此以后，你走你的阳关道，我过。Wow,
he said we were blood brothers yesterday, and today I sever that relationship with you. Let's go our separate ways.
我的独木桥，我大刀王五再也不认识你这姓华的。
Nothing to do with you。
别几许时，忽景殿飞来，忍不携20年文景交，同赴泉台，漫迎将去楚孤臣，箫声呜咽。
Who is this? This is not his child, I don't think.
敬至尊纲十余日。不死，甘永抛400兆为弩种，长埋地狱，只留得扶桑三杰，剑气。
Wow, fantastic penmanship! That is great, great calligraphy, great job.
魔空，二叔，我念的都对吧？一共72个字。
Oh, this is nephew. Okay,
72个字。在谭嗣同谭大人遇难之后，他的好友唐才常先生做的一副挽联，72个字，字字泪痕交加。
我让你教孩子写大字，你教的什么乱七八糟的？
爹，爹，您怎么又咳嗽上了？难道我大哥先请的郎中开的药方不管用吗？
我是被你给气的，2年来你这副挽联写了几千遍了，那么多的好诗句你不写，总写挽联干什么？
爹，儿是想表达一下对谭大人的怀念与敬重。
谭嗣同年纪轻轻就丢了性命，断了谭家的香火，他是谭家的不孝之子，有什么好怀念的？有什么好敬重的？君子不立危墙之下。儿啊，你和这种人交往，给咱们家带来多少麻烦，你知道吗？
我知道。2年前，老佛爷要砍戊戌六君子的人头，二叔在法场上捣乱，得罪了官府。要不是爷爷变卖了田产，买通了官府，二叔早就被抓进去坐牢了。
东方啊，你玩去吧，我跟你二叔。
Yeah, go sit your ass down. Grown folks is talking.
Yemo,
sure.
袁家，从今以后，你进书房就只练这一个字。
爹，那洋人用大炮轰开了大沽口，长驱直入，路过咱们家门口的时候，还开枪杀了人。您死活拦着我，我怕惹您生气，就没敢出门。这，您怎么还让我忍呐？
跟洋人打仗，那是朝廷的事，你还想出去挨枪子儿啊？不许学谭嗣同，不孝有三，无后为大。正日子已经定好了，下个月初八，三吉四喜的好日子。
什么日子啊？
跟你娶媳妇的日子啊！这桩婚事5年前媒人就已经说好了。
Oh, wow.
你一拖再……
he's been promised a wife. Interesting. Okay.
让我怎么向亲家交代呀？
爹，而武学未成，每天4更就起来练功，怎么娶媳妇啊？再说我也不想那么早就。
No time for a woman. I'm practicing martial arts. He's 30. Yikes.
早？你已过了而立之年，还说早？徒弟都一大堆
了，还没娶
妻生子，像什么样子？ 趁我还没死，赶紧把王家小姐娶过门，给霍家添丁进口。
你来了。
Do your duty。
王哥，王
兄弟，
来来来，师傅，您来了。
Uh-oh.
恭喜
来来来，
Is this the Bruce Lee character? Oh, snap.I think we're about to finally get some fighting. Yes. Section stab action. I love it.
三节棍贵在可近可远，攻守兼备。此处空间狭小，你想用三节棍出奇制胜，兵器选得对。但是今天我娶媳妇儿，是我大喜的日子，你把我们家水缸打烂了，你该当何罪啊？啊，你要是再把新郎官的鞋给弄湿了，那你的罪过就更大了。
师父，弟子错了，我这就上街买口新缸来，任您当大婚的贺礼。
只是买口新缸，
便宜你了，黄大少爷。Is this Bruce Lee?
那师父，那你还要啥呀？
起来吧。走了几年了？
六年。
六年长这么大个子，
我也不知道啊。母亲大人说是跟您学武以后啊，筋骨被撑开了，所以就长高了。
那这以后为师上街，你这么大个子跟在我身后，岂不把师父给比矬了？
那怎么办？哦，我知道了，以后上街跟着您，我这么走。
Okay, interesting episode. Full disclosure, this is my first time really watching a martial arts soap opera. I've never actually done that before. So I expect there to be some ebbs and flows. You know, that just comes with it. Every episode can't be chock full of martial arts goodness. There has to be a story, right? To keep you going. Yeah, you come for the martial arts, you stay for the story, right? I like it. I like it so far. I would imagine if the opener to the show is any indication of the martial arts that will come later, then I can wait for it. I want them to build a story. I don't just want to watch, you know, some trash. So I like what I'm seeing. There's a lot of heart that's built into this. Like I said, there's a theme about brotherhood and honor that's built into the episodes that I really dig. I like that a lot. The relationship between Hu Wanja and Big Sword Wang Wu, I would imagine it's going to have also some ebbs and flows as they start off as adversaries, become blood brothers, and now it looks like they're going to be adversaries again. Very interesting. Also, what I think is interesting, because in Fist of Fury, they don't tell us the story of Hu Wanja. In Fist of Fury, it really starts upon Bruce Lee's return that his master has been killed. So I like what they're doing here. They're giving us a full background of the character who would be Bruce Lee's teacher. So I'm really digging that. It's really good. I would give this on a scale of 1 to 10. I'll give this episode a 7.5, okay? But interested to see where this goes, see what the bad guy is gonna do now that he knows that, or suspects that Hu Wanja is helping Big Sword Wang Wu. He clearly has a beef with Big Sword Wang Wu and wants to probably capture and kill him. And so by proxy, he'll probably wanna capture and kill Hu Wanja as well. I love it. I think that this is, I think we're off to a good start. But tell us, what do you think? What do you think about this episode? Did you like it? Did you expect more? Did you want more action? Comment below and let us know, you know? And hey, we look forward to seeing you on the next episode. Until then, OG Ant in the building. We'll catch you. What's up?